Welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. Today we're gonna work with collisions in Gdevelop. Okay, we're gonna play a dying animation when our character collides with something. Here's the project we are working on. Okay, so here is the project of the worm. Alright, let's run this. I'm going to run this on Windows. And yeah, you can see that I made some changes to this. Okay, you can see some text on top there. And that is displaying a variable. Alright, so I'm going to collide with that car there now. It's sideways for some reason. And you can see that my character plays some sort of a really cheesy dying animation. Okay, so let's continue. Okay, so here is the original project. And yeah, so if you run this, you can see that we have no obstacles. Okay. So we want our worm to be able to die when he collides with an enemy. Let's check out our animations. Here are the animations, and we don't have a dying animation. Okay, we could create one quickly. Let's see if we can add one. We have this one here from the previous example, but I think I'd like to make a new one. Let me open the Photoshop very quickly. Actually, I will post a video how to get Photoshop free from Adobe. They have a loophole for people who don't have Adobe Photoshop. Okay, I don't know if you did that purposely. So, let me open the worm, opening a can of worms. So let's do some quick pixel art here. Let me just delete this here. And here is our final frame. Wow, only 4 frames. Very simple animation. And let's bring that into Gdevelop. 4 frames. Those are frames. Let's make a new animation. We have 0, 1, and 2. So this would be animation number 3. Dragged frames. And we don't want this to loop, okay? We just want this to play at a normal speed, maybe 0.3. Play it. Maybe a little faster. 0.2. That's not too bad there. Okay. Now we need a bad guy. Let me create something here quickly. I don't know what this is. It has legs and eyes. Maybe just one eye. It's some sort of angry thingy. And let's export this as bad guy. Oops. Okay, let's import our bad guy. Let's insert a new object, new sprite, and let's add our bad guy. Here it is. He's just a bad guy. Okay, so if you run this now, you can see that we have no collisions with the bad guy. So let's go to events, and let me move this up. Let's create a new event, and let's find collisions. Collisions, where are collisions? Collisions should be under objects. Collision. Let's select object 1, which would be our a worm. And we're colliding with the bad guy, which we should probably rename bad guy. Let's do that. edit. Oops. To bad guy. Okay. So collision between the worm and the bad guy. Okay. So if that happens, we are going to disable the controller. Actually, the one who found out about this is Alan Dan. He emailed me about it. It's on the platform behavior. And it's on the controllers. And what you do is you disable the controllers. Okay? You disable the controllers for the worm. Select the behavior. You have the controllers yes. And that's it. Let's preview this. And now I cannot move. Okay, but notice that I can still change directions. To avoid that, we're going to use a variable. Okay, so at the beginning of the scene, we are going to add a new variable. Here are variables. Now, right now, we don't have one, so let's create one. All you have to do is click on this plus button, and let's call the player alive. Okay, and the initial state is 0. Let's set this to 1. We're gonna make 0 when he's dead. Okay. So at the beginning of the level, this shows as 1. Okay, let me actually display that on a text. And we're going to need a text file, or a text object. I want to enable this. It's just gonna say text, okay, for now. Let's go to events, and here is our conditions. This condition is for the scrolling, so this happens all the time. Let's add it here. Let's see. Our text object. Let's modify the text. Select the text. And we want our text to display the variable. Okay, so here is our variable. Player alive. Let me delete the quotations there. And now that's going to display our variable. Okay, let's run this. Now it's set to 1. So when we collide with the worm, we're going to set that variable to 0. Select the variable. Set that to 0. Let's try it out. Set to 1 right now. And now it's set to 0. Now these two lines here turn our character around. Now we only want to turn around if our character is alive. Okay. Let's check with the variable. Player is alive equals 1. Okay. And I can simply just copy and paste that to the next line. And let's try it out. So now when I collide with the bad guy, I won't be able to move at all. You can see that my keyboard doesn't work anymore. So when the worm collides with the bad guy, we want to change this animation to our new animation. Let's go to sprites. Change the animation to I think it was 3. Let me double check. Yeah, it was animation 3. Okay, so let's run this. Let's go live with the bad guy. And there is our animation, but it freezes. Actually, let me bring the worm to front. Set the order of the bad guy to 1. And the order of the worm to 2. Okay, so that's going to bring it to the front. Let me double check. sort of works. So I guess we can copy this variable to the rest of the animations. Example, when he's jumping, as long as he's alive. When he's walking, as long as he's alive. And when he's on the floor, as long as he's alive. When he's falling. And I think that's it. Now if you run this, my best guess is that that's still not gonna work. Okay, it works. Try that again. Okay, that works fine. As I mentioned, this game engine is free. Okay. And there we go. Alright, so don't forget to like the video. Let me know in the comments down below what you think. Okay, so I will leave this example in the forum. Okay, so you can download it there. Yeah, sign up for the forum. Alright, thanks for watching. And I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.